Hello students, good morning. Today we will see English literature for the Victorian age. As it is evident from its name that this is the literature which was written during the reign of Queen Victoria is famously known as Victorian age literature. The literature of the Victorian period started from 1837 and lasted till 1901. And this literature of was preceded by Romantic age and it was followed by modernism or realism. Some if we see some historical background of the Victorian period, we see that this age, this era was era of peace. It was living some exception during the with a few colonial war that broke during the Victorian period. There was not too much disturbance. Second is material development. The new colonial emergency was conflicted in the Great Exhibition of 1851, and that bring a new kind of things in material development. The evils of industrial revolution and Reform Act passed in 1832. These all things brings a material development for this Victorian period. Intellectual development. Third is intellectual development. So there can be a little doubt that many material wealth produced a hardness, temper, and impatient project idea that got no written to the hardness. And of course, this was age in which intellectual development took place. Democracy again. Many countries, I mean, the social forces of this great age, democracy developed in many countries. And the last one is social unrest. Since because it was age of democracy and it is age of popular education, of religious tolerance, of growing brotherhood, and of the profound social so that's of profound social unrest also. Now we will see the main literary characteristic of the Victorian age. If we see that this Victorian period was just followed by some events of 1829, the Catholic Emancipation. Then we see parliamentary reform in 1832 and suppression of slavery in colonies in 1833, and then construction of first railway in 1830. And since after that Victoria come, okay, so this age was great social changes and age of great social changes and intellectual advancement. We see how this growth of democracy, reform bill of 1832, and education, elementary education become popular during this age. So number of readers gradually repeated this increase, and this production, industrial production, and epoch making advances of geological and biological studies. This disturb profoundly traditional or man's creation on the length of history and this planet. Second was, so this social unrest was the great disturbing feature of the Victorian era, and the demand for the social justice colored one way or the another the whole thought of this time. Second was Oxford movement. The Oxford movement was an attempt to recover the lost traditions. Of course, the pioneer of the Oxford movement, they want that some the traditions which are already lost, just how can we gain them? Third was moral purpose. So moral purpose is the keynote of the literature of the Victorian period. So as we have seen that they were from the purity aristocratic standard, they want of the art for art's sake, and to the acute by the definite moral purpose. Fourth is idealism. It is spoken also that this age is also a prosaic age lacking the great ideals. Fifth is intellectual development. As we have seen that in religious and ethical thought of the Oxford movement, it is called the most noteworthy advance. So people get up and they vote new intellectual development, new education by the Reformation Bill and the Education Act, making certain measures of equation here, education compulsory rapidly produced the enormous readers, and then intellectual influence of the foreign writers, and the last one, age of prose. Especially if we see Victorian age was age of prose, and then come to this in age of prose, we see novels. Novel was one of the best genre in which there are. Their novels were realistic novels, and they were thickly plotted. Their setting, their plot was very thick, and they were crowded with characters. A lot of characters were there in their characters. They were too lengthy, and they were published in serially. And they describe, all the novel describe contemporary life, especially the middle class. Now we see the great novelist of this period, and the best, the most famous is Charles Dickens. During his lifetime, Charles Dickens wrote many novels. The some of few famous novels of his were The Pickwick Papers, Oliver Twist, Nicholas Nickleby, David Copperfield, Bleak House, Our Time, Little Dorrit, A Tale of Two Cities, and the most famous is Great Expectations. Next one was William Makepeace Thackeray, who wrote two famous novels, Vanity Fair and History of Henry Esmond, which was a historical novel. Next, Emily Sisters, and the most famous is Emily Bronte. She wrote Wuthering Heights, and after writing this novel, she died. Her sister, Charlotte Bronte, wrote famously Jane Eyre and Volatile. Then come to George Eliot. George Eliot wrote Adam Bede, The Mill of Flowers, Silas Marina, Romola, Felix Salt, The Radical, Middlemarch, Daniel Drona. Then George Meredith. George Meredith wrote The Egoist and Diana of the Roseways. The last and the most famous of Victorian novelists is Thomas Hardy. He was a great pessimistic writer. He wrote many famous novels. Some of his famous novels are Far From the Madding Crowd, The Return of the Native, The Mayor of Casterbridge, Days of Dover Village, Life of Life's Little Ironies, and the last and the most famous one, Jude the Obscure. After this novel, he stopped writing novels. And some legend novelists of this period were Samuel Butler, who wrote Hooded Brass, R.L. Stevenson, Lewis Carroll, Benjamin Disraeli, George Gissing, Elizabeth Gaskell, and Vicky Collins. They were legend novelists. Thank you for today, and